They give you a business guidance. I'd say about 60% of my clients that go into these pivot. I know it's an overused word, but they do. I've been just totally changing, consumer face into enterprise. That's happened a couple times. Access to advisors. And then there's the osmosis effect of just being around other startups. It's exciting to just be around them and to pick up things and ideas and share ideas and collaborate with them. Keep in mind, you're giving up a good equity chunk. It's a huge time suck. And if you already have developed your product and you're going heads down, you are going to be giving up.
The third type of advisor, and I always ask clients this, so I want to give shares to an advisor. What kind of advisor is it?
Well, they're actually kind of a consultant. They're going to be giving you about 10 hours a month. They have a deliverable. Maybe you want to make them introduce you to five VCs or help you work on your product. It's kind of more of a consulting relationship. Here's what I find. The advisors that provide you more in terms of tangible benefits actually really want less in terms of equity. And the mentor. The advisors that offer you less are the ones that ask for more equity. The big name advisor. I want 2% of your equity because I did a Google search and I found out that's what's market. So what I in my general rule,
yeah,
and I said recently,
we do with some really high value advisors and we give them accelerated based on milestones. If they get stuff done that we need to get done, like a purchase or a launch or a certain user adoption, we'll give them accelerated investing, which is instant, as soon as they hit that.
I will always encourage my clients to run to the hills when they're talking about vesting terms that are based on anything other than objective criteria. The criteria you just mentioned are subjective. And because delivering something, well, you can have a fight over whether or not they made that deliverable.
No, if they hit 10 million user downloads and they hit number one and we get a sale, that's pretty objective.
So if it's objective,
mm-hmm.
then you're free to do it. But what I always find is 10 million downloads and then, you know, what is this mean? What is the metric?
Yeah,
what if we pivot?
It's 10 million because your sales guy made this big deal or your competitor went out of business.
Well,
or
10 million because that's where the guys are making off of the money.
So you're free to do whatever you want. What I would encourage you is everything should be time-based vesting, so it's completely objective. If they're working for you, they get their shares, not based on deliverables because you're leading yourself up into a dispute over whether or not they've met that. Final thing, this is the last thing. These aren't really connected. Is a convertible note or equity makes sense? Convertible notes, quick, easy to negotiate. All the angels are expecting them. Right? They're all, so most of them will do it. Some of them will refuse to do it, but most of them will. They're great for where you're raising less than 500K. They're an absolute must when you're doing dribble-in financings. All of my clients think, oh, I'm going to raise $750,000. It's like, okay, great. That's going to happen over 6 months from 30 different people who don't know each other. It doesn't all happen in the same day. So if the amounts are dribbling in over time, you need to do a convertible note. You can't do a preferred equity financing without it. Thank you.